Hello everyone and welcome back to this course that is History of Microsoft Dynamics 365. In this lecture we will see the module number 2 major features that were released in Microsoft CRM 1.0 and 1.2. In previous lecture we have seen the origin and roadmap of Microsoft Dynamics 365 from its first officially released version till date. So let me now introduce you to Microsoft CRM 1.0 and 1.2. Microsoft CRM 1.0 was released in January 2003 with a name Microsoft Business Solutions Customer Relationship Management 1.0, but that was too hard to pronounce and follow, so they have changed the name to Microsoft CRM 1.0. So this is the common homepage of Microsoft CRM 1.0, where you can see the activities for that particular logged in user, and from right hand side you can create a list of useful activities. So the navigation bar was at the bottom, where first you can see, you can navigate to homepage, workplaces, sales and service module, and at the end navigate to reporting module from bottom navigation bar itself. There was no marketing module in the first version of Microsoft CRM. So let us now see the different functionalities. Microsoft CRM 1.0. It included sales and service modules. It was possible to integrate CRM with Outlook. And the reports of CRM 1.0 were not built on SQL Server functionality, but yet leveraged the well-known Crystal Reports product at that time, which was later acquired by Business Object and which in turn was brought by SAP. Let us now see the limitations of that product as well. It was cumbersome to use and set up Microsoft CRM 1.0. It was very problematic and had many limitations and also required many changes for almost every installation for Microsoft Dynamics CRM 1.0, and it was not possible to perform any advanced customization task on CRM in a supported manner, such as adding new entities. Version 1.0 was released in English language only, so due to these changes Microsoft has to release an updated version in a short span of time. Microsoft has released CRM 1.2 that in December 2003 in the same year. CRM 1.2 allowed users easier everyday interaction with the system. Customizations could be made and maintained from a sophisticated user experience. It increased its language support offerings up to 9. It included international English, US English, French, Italian, German, Danish, Dutch, Spanish, and Brazilian Portuguese. It offered a number of service and product enhancements, including somewhat easier setup and more reporting options as well. But unfortunately, with these changes also, there were many limitations for CRM 1.2. Even with these changes, it suffered from usage and setup problems that made it less than ideal from the user and system administrator perspective. Diagnostic wizards sometimes overlook several key issues, resulting in failed or an aborted installations. So with these issues, customers has not adopted CRM 1.2 in a great manner. So Microsoft has realized that it needed to set up development efforts on CRM platform from its next release and devoted many more resources towards the next version. So on that note, we will wind up this lecture, and in our next module, we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 3.0. So I hope to see you all in the next lecture. Till then, bye bye and take care.